How's it going, guys? So this is the start of my RCXD build. Don't know how it's going to go. This is just a this is an Amazon radio controlled truck that was sent to me, and it's got a lithium battery, 7.4 volt, and it can take two of these as well in I think you call it in parallel, so it runs two big 7.4 volt battery, so it lasts ages, like half an hour it lasts for. We've got the brushless motor there as well, which is super powerful, super torquey. This little thing, you see, it's not much bigger than my hand, but it goes like a rocket. And so first up, what I'm gonna do, I have this aluminium sheet to protect it from BBs, because I'm using it for a tactical advantage. I'm not like some other YouTubers that build these things and then people can't shoot at them. So I'm protecting it from BBs. We've drilled the holes in the sheet of aluminium to fit over the shell. And I'm gonna now curve this to shape to give it some protection. So I've got the slight bend in it now. And what I've marked these here, so these bits here are gonna act as like a sort of a mud guard. And I'm going to fold and make some cuts there and there. I'm going to push this bit forward a little bit. Got some lights under there, so I still want to keep them. Right, now we've got our frame protection and our mud guards there now. It's time to work on the back end and the sides. The back end is now shaped in. So the back's protected a little bit. I've got the little mud guards there again. And it's time for a brew and a Biscoff.
So it turns out that the suspension's not really up to scratch. And with the weight of the camera, the back end just sits far too low. So I'm gonna have to upgrade the suspension, the springs on it. So I've cut up an old AEG spring and it fits perfectly. So the suspension's now uprated and the shell has been fabricated. Made BB proof and it's had a coat of desert coloured spray paint. It's time to give it a test run. Next up, we need to make sure it's BB proof because I do expect it is going to get shot up quite considerably.
So inside the actual chassis here, we've got two 7.4 volt lithium batteries and they're actually on charge at the moment with these cool little USB chargers that came with it. We've got the brushless motor here, so that gives it's very silent and extremely fast as well. We've got the wheelie bar on the back there as well, because with the weight of the camera on the back end, it is a bit wheelie prone to wheelie in. So we've got the wheelie bar there, so it should in theory stop it from flipping over. On this side here, let's get round here, we've got the, if you can see it in there, it's I think it's 2.4 gigahertz and it's got really good range on it. That I must have took it a good 120 meters and it didn't go out of range, so the range is really really quite something else on it. Here we've got the Alpha Flyer detonator and I'm not sure the range on these is, it's ridiculous range. It's something like 200 meters, I think it, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think it is 200 meters. You can connect any kind of pyro that is designed for these. I'm using Mark 5s with it, but then I've also got these things here which are electric matches and you can connect those to it, and these will allow you to use any type of pyro you want by connecting them to the fuse, like smokes or any kind of pyro. Yeah, so here's the remote control for it. And with the remote detonator installed on there, so just uncover, boom. The aerial's there as well, so for extended range if you need to. Didn't actually need to use that at all. And it's really fast, really nimble, and it's got two speed settings. So I'll just show you on that. Two speed settings, and the low setting is quick, and the high setting is just ridiculously quick. You need to have like a big open area for it. It does say on the box that it is waterproof, and I didn't have any issues with it in the wet at all. And where is it? The speed does say something ridiculous, like 40 miles per hour. I don't know if that's true or not. I would imagine it is getting quite close to it, but yeah, it's four-wheel drive as well. Here's some specs for you. Pause it if you want to. But yeah, cool little car. I'll put a link down to it in the description.
So this is how you go about arming the device, really. You take these little Mark V's, you plug them into the ports, doesn't matter which way around they go, and then you arm the device, ready to go now. Ready, as soon as you press that button, it's ready to bang. They are quite expensive little things, £6 each. I think in the future that I'm just going to use standard pyro with the electric matches. You don't get the instant bang, but they are a third of the price than these little things. I was running an Insta360 1R on the back of it, which gave full coverage, so I didn't miss anything, and it gave some really cool shots. Here are a few of the moments in game.
So at the game, it did take some punishment from the opposing team, which is absolutely fine. It's just what I expected. I'm using this for a tactical advantage, so I expected them to shoot at it, and they did it in force as well. But when they realised it was totally BB proof, it was quite funny seeing them run away. But yeah, you can see its war wounds there. The pyro actually demolished these clips here, these metal clips. So I'm probably going to have to put some new ones of those on before I use it again. The shell actually is quite heat resistant. There's a few scorch marks on there. Even the plastic hasn't really melted that much on the fake C4 there. You can see there it has a little bit, I guess. The fake circuit board there did actually fall off, and I had to improvise to put that on.
So if you haven't already seen it, head over to my main channel and check out the RCXD in action.